So in this video, we will start with Zener breakdown or avalanche breakdown. In last videos, already you have seen that when we have drawn the reverse characteristic, then we got a breakdown region there. Alright, the corresponding voltage is called breakdown voltage. So now the question is that what is this breakdown region and why it is found when the diode is in reverse bias? Okay, so for that, suppose this diode here I have considered and the diode is in reverse bias, because this N side of the diode, it is connected with positive of the battery and P side is connected with the negative, so it is the reverse bias mode. Alright, now while discussing about the depletion region and the barrier potential, that time I told you about a topic which is not a topic but a term which is called fictitious battery. Alright, so this fictitious battery means some potential which is developed here. This potential behaves like a small battery where the polarity of the battery is like this, and why it occurs already in the previous video I told you, so you can, if you did not remember, you can go through. So in this fictitious battery, the negative side of the battery is towards P side, right, and the positive side of the battery is towards inside. So this battery is practically, it is not existing actually, but there exists a barrier potential, and the barrier potential is like a small battery which is there or which is present in the depletion region. We are just considering it in this way. Okay, now say when it is in reverse bias, you can see that the polarity of this battery and the polarity of the fictitious battery are same, isn't it? Because left side is positive for this also, right side is what, negative for this also. So since their polarity is same, can we say that this potential is actually adding some more potential in this fictitious battery? And that is why, if you remember, I told you that in reverse bias, the depletion regions gets broadened, that means gets thick, okay? And in reverse bias, sorry, in forward bias, it gets thinner. I told you about this one. So why it gets thick? See, this battery is contributing more potential in the depletion region, and as a result, the depletion region becomes thick. Alright? Now the question is that if we are applying this voltage, which is in reverse bias, or to keep the diode is in reverse bias, then this voltage is contributing some more voltage in the depletion region. And as a result, what happened is, in the depletion region, we don't have any free charge carrier, but we have some atoms in the depletion region. So if we have some atom, in the outermost shell of atom, what we know, that we have valence electron, the valence electron are there in the outermost shell. So what happened is, due to a very large potential developed in the depletion region due to this battery, right, some electrons from the valence level or from the valence shell, they come out of the atom. And once the electrons come out of the atom, in the depletion region there will be a huge increase in the number of electrons. So those electrons, now what will happen, due to this potential applied, now those electrons will start moving according to the direction of the potential. And once the electron starts moving, we will get a huge amount of current in the circuit. And due to that region only, see in the graph, initially we were getting less current, and once it crosses a certain voltage means what, when this voltage becomes enough to make the electrons of the, that is to make the valence electron to come out of the atom, if this voltage is sufficient, then beyond this voltage, what we are getting a sharp increase in current. That means the current in the circuit abruptly increases, and this kind of breakdown is called Zener breakdown. Okay, because here in this particular topic we are discussing about the breakdown region. Why do we get a breakdown region in reverse characteristic? Now this breakdown region can be occurred either by Zener breakdown or by avalanche breakdown. So the phenomenon that I discussed just now, it is called Zener breakdown. And here I have written the definition also, this one, due to very strong electric field beyond a particular value, because the electric field or the voltage has to cross a particular value, this value, okay? So beyond a particular voltage in the depletion region, bound electrons come out of the atom and thus a large amount of current is observed. This type of breakdown is called Zener breakdown. Alright, now another kind of breakdown also is observed in reverse bias, that is called avalanche breakdown. So now we are discussing about avalanche breakdown. So in avalanche breakdown, what happened is, here I have written that in reverse bias, the minority charge carrier get huge energy beyond a particular voltage. Okay, so minority charge carrier, if you remember, in reverse bias mode I told you that the current is obtained in the circuit which is very less, in the order of few microampere, and that current is due to what? Due to the minority charge carrier. Because see here, in this N region we have a few numbers of hole, we have a few number of holes, right? This one is a hole, there is a hole. So when in for reverse bias, this positive side, it is pushing this hole to cross this depletion region, okay, but the number of hole is very less. And here also some number of electrons are present in P side, those are the minority carriers. So this negative side of the battery, it will push this electron and they will cross the depletion region, and as a result we get current, that is a very small amount of current, okay. Now while crossing the depletion region, if you suddenly, or not suddenly but gradually, if you change this potential, these minority carriers while crossing the depletion region, they are getting a huge amount of energy, right? They are getting a huge amount of energy, and as a result what happened is, this electron strike the atoms present in the depletion region and knock out the electrons or the valence electron present inside the atom. The phenomenon is quite same with the Zener breakdown. In Zener breakdown, this knocking out, this process does not take place. There only due to the huge electric field, the electron come out of the atom. But in avalanche breakdown, those minority carrier, they get a very high amount of or huge amount of energy due to this battery, and then the strike of the electrons, the valence electron from the atom, and as a result those electrons come out of the atom. And once they come out, what they will form? They will produce a huge amount of current in the circuit, and as a result again we get some kind of breakdown region. Alright, this kind of breakdown region again we get. Now another thing you have to remember, that this breakdown region, as I told you, that we are getting it for Zener breakdown also, we are getting this kind of region for avalanche breakdown also, but Zener breakdown is small as compared to avalanche breakdown. This one I have written here. Zener breakdown takes place first and then avalanche breakdown. That means, suppose for an example, we have a diode, and the Zener breakdown or the Zener voltage at which the diode breaks down is, suppose it is 8 volt, not 8 volt, suppose it is 10 volt, okay. At 10 volt, just an example, okay. So at 10 volt, suppose Zener breakdown takes place, then we will get a huge amount of current in the circuit. Then after, once you increase the voltage up to 12 volt suppose, then you will get avalanche breakdown. Then again the current, again means then the current in the circuit will increase more. Alright, so Zener breakdown takes place first and then avalanche breakdown. So I hope it is clear. Then in next video we will discuss about diode as rectifier. One more thing before we go for this diode as a rectifier, one thing you have to remember, that for what purpose generally we use a diode? The main function of a diode is that when the diode is in forward bias, it actually conducts, because we get the current in milliampere range. But if the diode is in reverse bias, the diode conducts means this conduction or the current is very less, which is in the order of microampere. So that is why we almost consider that the diode does not conduct in reverse bias. That is the concept, that a diode only conducts in forward bias, but the diode does not conduct in reverse bias. Okay, this thing or this principle of diode we will use while discussing the diode as a rectifier. Another thing, there are some diodes like a Zener diode which acts in reverse bias also. Also means actually basically it works in reverse bias only, but this time from your syllabus this Zener diode part is omitted. So that is why we are not discussing about it. But just you can remember that there are such diodes like Zener diet and other types of diets are also there, which basically works only in reverse bias condition. Okay, so for today this much only. Then in next video we'll discuss the diet as rectifier.